Here, we have a function f of x. To the left of 1, let's put a point on the function, x. Now, what happens as we slide x closer and closer to 1 without actually reaching it? As x approaches 1, notice that the function value of x approaches 2. Now, what about from the right? As x approaches 1 from the right, f of x approaches 2 as well. So we see that from both the left and the right, as the x value gets infinitely closer and closer to 1 from either side, f of x seems to approach 2. This is called a limit. A limit is the value a function gets closer to as the input approaches a certain number. In our example, we would say that the limit of our function, f of x, as x approaches 1, is 2. To notate a limit, first we write lim for limit, and under this we put the x point and an arrow pointing towards the value it's approaching. To the right of this, we put our function. If you see a limit whose target value has a plus or minus sign, this does not mean positive or negative. This means we are finding a one-sided limit. As the name implies, a one-sided limit is taken from only the left or the right. A minus sign tells us to find the limit from the left, and a plus sign is the limit from the right. For a limit to exist, the one-sided limits must exist and be equal. Let's see what this means. In this example, does the limit of f of x as x approaches 3 exist? Well, let's first take the limit from the left. As x approaches 3 from the left, the function seems to approach 6, so that's the one-sided limit from the left. On the other hand, taking the limit from the right, the function seems to approach 0, so both one-sided limits exist but are not the same. Therefore, the overall limit of f of x as x approaches 3 cannot exist. Here's another example. Does the limit of f of x as x approaches 2 exist? Well, taking the one-sided limits, as x approaches 2 from the left, f of x approaches 4. From the right, f of x also approaches 4. The one-sided limits are the same. So this means the limit of f of x as x approaches 2 is 4. Notice that although f of 2 is undefined, the limit still exists. As long as the one-sided limits exist, we're fine. Now, let's move over to negative 2. What is the limit of f of x as x approaches negative 2? Well, taking the limit from the left, as x approaches negative 2, f of x seems to approach negative 1. From the right, as x approaches negative 2, f of x approaches 2. The one-sided limits do not agree, thus the limit does not exist. For a limit to exist, the one-sided limits must exist and be the same. So far, all the limits we've evaluated were on graphs, so let's try finding some limits using tables. Using the data from this table, can we find the limit of f of x as x approaches 4? Well, let's first sketch the points. Using the values smaller than 4, or to the left of 4, what value does f of x seem to approach? Well, as the distance between the x point and 4 gets smaller and smaller, the function seems to approach 1. So from the data, we can conclude that the limit of f of x as x approaches 4 from the left is 1. Notice a few things here. First, notice that the distance between the x point and 4 gets a lot smaller the closer x gets to 4. This is important in a limit, since the idea behind a limit is to get infinitely close to an x value while not reaching it. Without this detail, we would not be able to estimate the one-sided limit. Also, notice that it is possible that somewhere between 3.999 and 4, there's a massive spike or something unexpected. So the limit might be something else. But from what we can see on the table, 1 is a really good estimate for a one-sided limit. And lastly, notice that although the function value does exist, the limit is not 3. Remember, the limit is not dependent on the value of the function. So we found that the limit of f of x as x approaches 4 from the left is 1. What about from the right? Well, plotting the points given on the right, or the numbers greater than 4, we see that as the distance between 4 and the x value gets smaller and smaller, f of x is getting closer and closer to 1. So we can conclude that the limit from the right is 1 as well. And look at that. The two one-sided limits exist and are equal, so we know that the limit of f of x as x approaches 4 is 1. Okay, here's another table. If we were told to find the limit of g of x as x approaches 2, can we conclude that it is 4? Well, no. If we plot the points, we see that the gaps are too large. In order for the limit to be 4, we need something like this. But this graph isn't guaranteed. There might be something crazy going on in the middle. The table just doesn't have enough information. So to use a table to evaluate a limit, the x values must get closer and closer to the target value, and both limits must be the same. If the gaps are too large, there just isn't enough data to provide a reasonable conclusion. So that's an introduction to limits. In the upcoming videos, we're going to build upon this concept, so make sure you subscribe. And if you enjoyed this video or learned something new, don't forget to leave a like and share it with a friend. Now, keep working hard and keep learning. Thank you for watching.